Hi, today we're going to learn more about the graph view. It is important to understand this tool because it is extremely helpful for controlling the movement between your keyframes. We're going to create an animation of an object moving in a circle of motion using the graph view. I've prepared a simple circle with one bone in the middle for us to animate. Let's go to animate mode. First, type 1000 for both X and Y on frames 0 and 40. Then go to the middle of the animation, frame 20, and key the ball again at the value of negative 1000 for X and Y. Select all the keys and turn the curves to Bezier. This gives us a linear movement. Since we want to create a circular movement, we need to offset the translate X curve. Let's first separate translate X and Y for the bone in the tree view, then enable offset and move the translate X curve 10 frames. If you shift the timing of one of the two curves by 20 frames, you change the circle rotating from clockwise to counterclockwise. Keep this technique in mind when you're animating. You can change a linear translation into a curved one by simply sliding the timing of separate X and Y curves. This will help you create arcs and make your animation less robotic and more organic. Let's make a circular motion using a different method. This method is simpler, but it uses an additional bone and may not be applicable for every situation. Let's create a new bone and make it the parent of our circle bone. Then we go to animate mode and create a new animation. Move the circle bone to an X value of 1000. Then key rotate the parent bone at the value 0 on frame 0 and 360 on frame 40. Leave the curve linear. To change the direction of the rotation, just change the rotate key on frame 40 to negative 360. The graph view is an essential tool that every animator should master. In this simple but fundamental example, we can see how the graph view visualizes the motion as curves. This gives us great power to identify and fix kinks in our movement that cause jerkiness in our animation. Just by looking at the shape of our curves, we can improve our animation. One last tip. Turn on the ghosting view and see what happens when you offset the curves. This is especially helpful when you're new to using the graph view. Have fun and happy animating!